Very, very big companies like Google, Facebook, Amazon, they are trying to implement this DevOps technology as part of his development philosophy, because it really helps you to keep on working, provides feature faster, and in a very much more secure way.
Hello and welcome to a fresh chapter of Turing DevTalks, where we take you through the key concepts of skill sets and technologies that top American companies look for when hiring senior software engineers. I am Alina, your host for the day, and I am tuning in from India. Today we have a very special guest on the panel, Juan, who is joining us all the way from Colombia. Hi, Juan.
Hi, everybody.
So Juan has 6 years of experience with DevOps, and he has worked on web frameworks like Django and Laravel. And today he's here to talk about DevOps, the future of DevOps, and how it is all about automatic deployment. This video will be divided into two parts. The first part will take you through the key challenges that DevOps is trying to overcome in the software industry, a few good reasons to learn DevOps in 2022, and finally give you a detailed insight into what the career path of a DevOps engineer looks like. The second video will cover the lifecycle of DevOps, the benefits of learning DevOps, and the technical skills that developers need to build a career in DevOps. The link to the second video will be mentioned in the description below. Now, I think without further ado, let's get started. So first of all, thank you so much, Juan, for joining us for this discussion. And how are you doing?
Great, great. Thanks, Alina. It's a pleasure to be right here. I'm good. Actually, the weather today is pretty nice. Sometimes right here in Bogota, Colombia, actually that I'm in Bogota. The weather is so crazy. You can just have the four seasons in a single day. So actually today, I hope it will be a summer day.
That sounds awesome. Okay, so Juan, 6 years in DevOps, and that definitely sounds like a lot. And I'm sure you would have thoroughly enjoyed working in this field all these years. How has your experience been this far, and how has it evolved according to you over the last 6 years?
Great. Actually, 6 years ago, they were definitely less tools than what we have today to do our job. We have to set it up many things manually. There was just the rising of some tools that are just part of the DevOps technology today, like Docker and Kubernetes. So actually we have many things less to do. We have to do many operative things like setting up a server, ensuring that the app is running manually, checking the application to be sure that it was up. So when I just look at the past, I think that definitely DevOps have changed a lot so fast, and just helping us out as developers, as an operators of the IT management infrastructure so much. And I think that one of the most amazing things of working at DevOps, it is an opportunity to be involved in the whole process. So absolutely, it's absolutely incredible to look at how much have it changed from those 6 years.
Absolutely. I can only imagine the thrill of working in DevOps. And the way you speak of it, I'm sure you would be enjoying your job a lot.
Yeah, sure.
And I also believe that the word DevOps was coined only in 2009 by Patrick DuBois. How then do you think companies functioned before the whole idea of DevOps came into existence?
Actually, there was many things that you have to do by yourself. The development and the operational team were completely isolated. So one part of the team was just working on coding, and the other part was just ensuring that the code was okay, that the infrastructure to deploy the code was okay. So actually create some delays, because once the people finish coding, they have a complete different team to test it out, to check. And sometimes the bugs and errors into the code base was known like weeks before. So it was like a very manual process, testing the things had to be manual. So actually the possibility of errors during the testing environment was high. So I think that everything was just like a little bit slower. Actually, DevOps is just right here to make things faster and better. So actually many things of the development and operational team needs to be manual with a high probability of error and much more slower than today.
Okay, that sounds like DevOps has solved a lot of problems in the industry with its existence.
Yeah, sure. It's been like that extra piece that makes everything works smoother and better.
Okay, interesting. I think it would be fair to say that DevOps is not only helping teams collaborate, but is also bringing about a revolution in the software industry.
Yeah, sure. Actually, we have many things that are being improved in the DevOps environment, just like the testing things, the lower probability of errors because all the testing is being automated. So it makes it much more efficient way to develop and deploy that developments into the production environment that is the actual application that the customers use every day.
Right. So now that we're on the topic, can you also walk us through the kind of challenges that DevOps is trying to overcome in the industry?
Yeah, sure. When you're working on an application, you try to look in a very big insight of how it will be. You try just to visualize everything done. But when working with DevOps, the first thing that it achieves is to convert that huge idea into small pieces. So once you have that thing of DevOps, it really helps you so much because you will be able to work on little tasks that keep on your task running and working. So actually it helps so much. As I told you, the testing is so much more, it's really easier than it was before because we have a whole process of automated testing that flags a deployment as successful or unsuccessful automatically and lets you know what could be happening into the application if that is deploying to production before doing so. So I think that's why very, very big companies like Google, Facebook, Amazon, they are trying to implement this DevOps technology as part of his development philosophy, because it really helps you to keep on working, provides feature faster, and in a very much more secure way.
Okay, that definitely sounds like DevOps engineers have a bright future ahead.
Sure, yeah. We are just keep on working. Many companies are just trying to implement DevOps, and they need DevOps engineer to work there.
True. In fact, one survey suggests that 74% of companies have implemented DevOps in some fashion. How true do you think these numbers are? And according to you, what does the demand of DevOps engineers look like in the near future?
Ray, so something it's been happening during, let's say, those last 3 or 4 years is the change of the mindset of the IT industry. As it was adopted first by huge companies, firstly, we thought something like, hey, that's for Google, that's for Amazon, that's for Facebook. We don't have to implement it. But with the appearance of those new technologies, even the early startups are implementing DevOps as part of their philosophical engineering culture. So you can just find really early startups trying to implement everything using Kubernetes, Docker. Actually, GitLab surveys projected an increase of 122% in the next 5 years. So it's actually a need in the market. I think that all the DevOps technology will be implemented as a standard into the industry. So I think that the near future will be brilliant for everybody who wants to learn about DevOps engineering.
These numbers are incredible. In fact, I think all software engineers must try and must consider shifting to DevOps.
Yeah, that's it.
If you're a software engineer with 3+ years of experience in the software industry and are looking for elite jobs in the Silicon Valley, your wait is over. Head on to Turing.com/jobs and sign up on the platform today. Now, coming back to you, Juan, we've learned a lot about DevOps in the last few minutes, I'm sure. But why do you think developers must learn more about DevOps? And can it pave a better career path for senior developers?
Absolutely. I think that DevOps is a huge branch of technology. It's not like learning a new programming language. It involves so many things. So I think that learning one of those bases will help you out in doing different things. If you are just working for testing, there is so many tools that helps you create an automated testing that makes it everything much more easier. And I think that trying to work on those aspects makes you a better software engineer and makes your work even easier to test it out. Talking about, for example, the security, if, for example, you're a security software engineer, you can just learn so much from DevOps, create a new way of deploying things in a safe way. And one of the things I will highlight more is the container technology. You can just get your own production environment into your computer. So it really helps you to create software in a better way. No matter if you're doing a small website, you can just have your production environment into your machine and prevent errors before they happen in production environment. So there are many things that really helps you, no matter if you are software engineer, back-end developer, front-end developer, it really helps in every aspect to get a better insight of the development and the whole chain and prevent errors before they happen.
So I think these are some very convincing reasons to learn more about DevOps, especially if you are already in the software industry. But before we move on, Juan, could you also give us a clearer picture of what the career path of a DevOps engineer looks like?
Right. Actually, you can find many things to do. You can learn different aspects of the DevOps technology, the testing environment, monitoring environment, deployment environment. As I told you, the big giants of technology are using DevOps. There are many tools that helps you to get in touch with every piece of DevOps technology. The testing environments, they provide tools to test your artifacts or deployments before doing into production. The pipelines that helps you to create a different way to deploy the code into your production environment. And the monitoring that will really helps you. And I think that if you feel a little bit like you're doing always the same, I think that DevOps will change that thing forever, because every day will be a different challenge, will help you to get in touch with a different aspect of the software engineering career. And definitely it will help you to create better code in a very much more efficient way.
Honestly, after knowing all of this, I will be looking up to learn more about DevOps, and I'll be looking for resources to learn DevOps. But I think you'll be sharing all of those with us in the next part, right?
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. So we'll be having Juan with us again in the next video, where he will be covering the life cycle of DevOps, the benefits of learning DevOps, technical skills that developers need to build a career in DevOps, along with a few learning resources. And I think you should definitely stay tuned for the next video. You'll find the link to the part 2 in the description below. Till then, hit the bell icon and stay tuned for more updates. Like and share this video with your friends and family. Let us know in the comments below what you would like to learn more in the upcoming videos. Thank you so much for staying tuned with us. Subscribe to Turing.com and happy working.